Christina Muryn with the City of Findlay. As we work through the COVID-19 situation in the Findlay-Hancock County community, I wanted to take this opportunity to remind you a couple of things. One, continue to support our local businesses. Obviously, we have to make it look a little bit different on how we support them, but they're still open and you can still support them. So check out some of the businesses in town and how you can order carryout or buy items online to support them during this time. Additionally, it's important that our business community continue to follow the directions of the governor's orders, making sure you're providing opportunities for social distancing in the workplace, continuing to sanitize on a regular basis, and checking employees' temperatures are three critical ways you can protect our community. So make sure to continue to follow the governor's orders, visit coronavirus.ohio.gov for up-to-date information, and call the mayor's office or Hancock Public Health with any questions.
Friends and neighbors, we live in a blessed community and we've always persevered. Certainly these are unsure times, but you need to rest assured that our local health professionals, community leaders, businesses, teachers tutoring from home, local grocery store servers are still out there making sure our shelves are stocked so we shouldn't have the anxieties that maybe you're seeing on a national level. We'll continue to strive locally to make sure we're meeting your needs, to work together, to collaborate, and to work through this one day at a time together. Certainly as a person of faith, please keep in mind that we shall persevere. Have a blessed day. Thank you.
Hi, I'm Bill Kose, Chief Medical Officer at Blanchard Valley Health System. A couple of things I'd like to cover for our community. Everyone has been working together for really an extended period of time. Blanchard Valley Health System, including Bluffton, has a plan. We've established a community triage area outside of the hospital. We have a phone number 24/7. 419-423-7890, that individuals that have questions about contagiousness, could they have the disease, what should they do, can make a phone call and we will answer the question. If we feel you need to be seen, we'll make an appointment, specifically an appointment that you can come in and we will check you to make sure things are okay. What should you be looking for? Well, if you have a cough, if you have respiratory symptoms, if you're short of breath, if you're fatigued, and if you're concerned that you may have been exposed, those are certainly reasons to make a phone call to the hospital to see how things are going. In general, we are prepared. I made rounds today at the hospital and informed them that we had our first case of the virus. It was not determined to be found at the hospital, but our people expected that. This is not a when, this is not an if, it's a when. We knew that. Individuals are prepared. The emergency room has capacity, we have capacity on the floors, we are prepared for any kind of a scenario that would occur. So again, I go back, do the right thing. Stay home, take care of yourself, talk to other people, reassure people we are in this for a long haul. We have preparations that have been made along with law enforcement, with governance, with public health. And I think we're in a pretty good place. This is and continues to be an amazing community.
Hi, I'm Karim, Baroudi, Public Health Commissioner here in Hancock County. And I want to start by urging everybody to please wash your hands, cover your sneeze and cough, and distance yourself. You know it's here. It's scientific proof that it's spreading amongst us. It's extremely important what we do today to how we're going to end up, you know, next week or the week after. I want to assure you, we are prepared. We will get through this. It's just our individual actions and behavior in the next couple weeks that's going to determine how many of us are going to contract the virus.
Question for you as a public health professional. What is public health's role in this epidemic?
Absolutely. Public health has been doing surveillance and kind of watching each and every test that's been done, watching like the community. And our role would be, once that first case is identified, we will make contact and we'll make sure to contact and trace. That's a very important function of what we do as disease investigators for the community and to keep the community safe. So again, I've said it before, I want to say it again. I don't want you to worry. If you've been in contact with a positive, we will contact you. We will reach out to you. I don't want anybody to panic. It's very important that we keep calm, follow instructions, follow the science, and we will be okay. I'm gonna take the opportunity to remind everybody, get your information from a reputable source. It's extremely important. There's a lot of stuff going on the internet, a lot of stuff going on social media. I want you to reach out and go to the right place. It's very important to keep you safe and keep your neighbors safe.